ain't no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here again with another video. And I want to start this video off by saying sorry that I didn't upload anything last Thursday and Saturday. I just got busy and I didn't get time to record anything. But now I do. So in this video, we are going to be on the Belgique Profond map. I think that's how you say that. I've been playing on this map a little bit. It's a nice little map. It gives me a chance to use some smaller equipment and older equipment. So I'm going to start this off. I will show you guys around the farm, show you what I've done so far, and then we will do some work. So we'll start up here. We'll start over in this shed. So here we have the John Deere 2100 Ripper. We got the John Deere 630 cultivator, or disc. We have the Aguias, I think this is how you say it, Aguias Tenius 18-ton trailer. We can use this for hauling our grain, as well as taking fertilizer and stuff to our fertilizer and seed to our equipment. Here we have the Air National 6200 drill. This, I can't remember where I found it. I downloaded it and added some spec maps to it so that it gets dirty now. Here we have the John Deere MaxiMerge 7200 12-row planter. I believe it's 12. Yep, 12. And then here we have this Panion fertilizer spreader. I've had this forever, but never really used it. So figured I'd use it today. Here we have the Chevy, what is it? Oh, just says farm truck. I think it's a 3500 truck. Can't remember if I bought any dairy cows or not. Nope. I think I just bought beef for animals. No, I bought, oh, that's right, they're not in the barn. I forgot about that. Yep, and then I did buy beef. Then if we hop over into here, here we have the John Deere 4840, the International 1586, and then the International 5488. And if we go over here, I got some stuff in here. There's our dairy cattle, and then if we go over here, here are the beef cattle. So in here we have the Wilson Ranch Hand Trailer for hauling our beef to market. And then here we have the little car trailer, that the Riverbend trailer that Mudbone had made. We gotta go up this way. So we just have this mixing station that's on here, so I just decided I'll use this rather than a mixing wagon. I very rarely use this thing, actually, if a map has it, but decided I would. In here we got some pallet forks, we got the dual rack for the 5488, we have some bale spears, a bucket, and then the JCB Powerboom 260 skid steer. And then we'll go down over here. In here we got a forage wagon, so that way we can make haylage. We'll be making silage that way. We got a Jatco sprayer, I think. Some kind of a foreign sprayer, but it's kind of neat. We got the Deutz Far 6095 combine, and then it's corn header, grain head, and then a trailer that I downloaded. Basically, someone took the in-game header trailers and added the locking function to them, so that was nice. Here we got the Mandeco LR45 to add moisture. We have the Case Spirit of 76. This is the 1570 American version, pulling the Roll Belt 450 New Holland baler that Random Sparks had edited up. And then we got a couple things over here, I think. Here we have the PJ Gooseneck trailer. This is going to be to haul our hay bales. And then, if we go here, we have the John Deere Model A and the John Deere 37 sickle bar mower. I just finished cutting that field of hay yesterday with it, and now today's plan is to rake it all with the Farmall 300 and New Holland 258 side delivery rake. I need to turn my game volume down. So we are going to go ahead and get started. So I need to get this guy up into fifth gear. And we'll turn the rake on and we will get at it. I thought that this one would ted it as well. I guess not. Because it did in 13, but evidently they didn't keep that function. Which is alright. I don't really hardly ever use tedders anyways. I just cut it and bale it. So yeah, this the John Deere Model A was in the small farming pack in 13, but that was converted separately. So the small farming pack just basically consists of equipment. They don't have any of the tractors in there anymore. I believe that the Farmall 300 was in that pack. There was a... No, the Oliver was separate. The Model A was in that pack, I remember, and then can't remember anything else. It's definitely a nice little pack. The sickle mower, I was hoping that it would get converted over, because eventually I want to make a model of what we use at our farm to cut hay. We use two Rouse 18-foot double sickle mowers, so I want to make one of those for Farm Sim. And then I can use the John Deere sickle mower as reference for the scripts and, you know, that kind of stuff, how it works. In a way, just kind of use it for reference. When I do my sickle mower, I actually want to script it so that it is mouse controlled for the sickles. So you can actually adjust, you know, like if you're on a hill, you can adjust the back one to be, you know, higher up for the hill, or you know, the front one lower, or, you know, in each one individually, you know, like you can in real life, which I think would be a really cool addition. And then, you know, it's what we use. We used two of them last year at the end of the 2014 season. My uncle had bought a second one, because we only had one at the time, and my uncle had gone and bought a second one. Because in 2014 we used the one Rouse sickle mower, and then we mainly used that for ditches, but we did cut a lot of the hay with it. And then we have two versatile swathers. I forget, I think we have two versatile 400s, I think is what we have. And then we use my dad's John Deere, I think it's a 2200 or 2220 swather. I believe it's a 2200 series, at least. But that had broken down halfway through the season. And actually, just a couple days ago here, we went and got parts for it. And we had to go all the way down to South Dakota to get them. So... Alright, now we will go this way and make a windrow. But yeah, then at the end of the 2014 season, my uncle had went and bought another double mower. And so then we used two of them last year, and that was all that we used. And we went through the hay pretty quickly. Because you can cut it and then, like, you know, if it doesn't get rained on the next day, you can rake it and bale it. And there you go. At least in some spots, some places was, you know, it was thicker and needed to dry a little longer. But yeah, it was, we got a lot of hay last year. We need about 2,000 bales to make it through the winter, and we had about 3,000. I thought that we had almost 4,000, but my dad said it was actually just about 3,000. I thought we had a lot of extra, but I guess I was thinking we had more extra than we actually did. So, but yeah, so this video is going out tomorrow, which is Tuesday. I'm recording this on Monday. Then after this video, you know, because I won't get all of this raked in this video, I don't think. So what I'm going to do is I'll do this video, and then once I finish it, I'm going to finish all the raking, and then the next video will be the baling, and I'll either record that later today or maybe tomorrow morning. Now, it depends on how long it takes, I guess. I was going to say something else. Tomorrow I'm going to be taking my driver's test to get my license. So, I do that at like 2 in the afternoon, I think. So I'm excited for that. What was it? Not last night, Saturday night. I sat and practiced parallel parking for about an hour at my dad's. So then I actually know the route that they are going to be taking on the test tomorrow. So I'm going to today practice that, drive that a time or two, and then practice parallel parking a little more, and then take that tomorrow and hopefully pass. And then Wednesday, I take the final GED test. I was supposed to take that 2 weeks ago, but the GED company wasn't testing and did not notify me that they weren't. So I showed up to take the test, and nobody was there, which really sucked. That's right, I need to switch. But yeah, so gonna be taking it on Wednesday. So hopefully I can pass that, and then I'm done. And then once the 26th comes, I'm going to be working at a fireworks stand for over the 4th of July. So I'll be working there in the afternoons. But I'll still be able to record videos because I won't be starting until like 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So I'll have plenty of time during the day to, or during the mornings, to record. Alright, there's the dual rack from the case. But yeah, so then once I finish that job, you know, since it's just temporary, then once that's done, I'm going to go find a full-time permanent job, find something different, and then also, guys, I did a video announcing that I was going to do a Q&A when I reach 1,500 subscribers, so if you haven't already, make sure that you go ask your questions on that video, or either on YouTube, or Instagram, or Facebook. I will link that video down below in the description. So if you haven't already asked, you can go ask your questions. So far, I've gotten a lot of questions, a lot of good ones, and then some that I just deleted, mainly on Instagram because they weren't really regarding that. They were just kind of random questions that got answered by other people. So, yeah, but we are at, as of this morning, when I looked, I was at, or no, it was last night I looked, I was at 1,463, so we got 37 subscribers to go, and then I'll make the video. I won't make it until I reach 1,500 subs, because, you know, I could make it now, and then people would ask a bunch of questions yet, and then they wouldn't get answered, which would not be right, so. But yeah, so then I guess I'll basically be making 3 videos here in the next, between today and tomorrow, hopefully. You know, I'll be making this video for Tuesday, and then I'll make a baling video for Thursday, and then right away after that, you know, once the baling's done, I'll make a video of hauling and stacking the bales for Saturday's video. So I'm gonna get a lot of videos recorded in advance. I'm probably gonna do some more videos on this map just because it's a nice little map. You know, it's smaller, it's a little bit older fashion, so you can use, you know, like this small farm equipment and, you know, some smaller equipment. Eventually I want to get the John Deere 4995 swather and, you know, use that and then get a different baler maybe, but for now this stuff is gonna work. The old iron is definitely nice. Definitely a change to go to using this stuff after using big stuff, but the older stuff is always more fun to use, in my opinion. Especially if it's a well done mod. You know, if it's done nicely like this small farm pack is, then it's definitely fun to use. But there was some Alice Chalmers tractors that were done a while back that the quality of them wasn't so great. So they, you know, weren't the greatest mods ever, but they worked, I guess. That's about all I can say. I'm kind of cutting that way too close. And that's not really what I wanted to do with that windrow, but oh well. Yeah, I got a lot of positive feedback on the video of my Meridian fuel trailer that I just completed last week. Very thankful for that. Now, my next project, I'll show you guys that eventually, is a 1982 or an 87. Either a 1982 or a 1987 Chevy C30. It's a SketchUp model, but I'm redoing it in Blender, so that it's not so many polys, not so many pieces, and then also giving it AO textures, making it dirt compatible. So that'll be nice. And then once that's done, I'm going to be making a large fleet of old iron equipment, older International tractors, older Case tractors, older John Deere, Alice Chalmers, Gleaner. Maybe I'll do some like Minneapolis Moline farm all stuff, but you know, that's not for sure at this point. That's just kind of a little idea, I guess. But yeah, so I'll be making, you know, tractors, combines, you know, like for John Deere, I'll make an old John Deere 95 combine. You know, and Gleaner, making old Gleaner, you know, like a Gleaner F maybe or something, you know. My first project out of that pack will be a Alice Chalmers 7060 black engine version. That's what my grandpa used to have, was a 7060 black engine. I saw there's some red ones, you know, where the engine and frame is red, but my grandpa's was black, so I'm gonna make that one. And yeah, so that's gonna be kind of cool. I kind of went and sat on Google one night and just kind of searched some different things for, you know, John Deere and those brands that I'm planning on doing, and found some equipment that I want to do and some other stuff. One of the things I'm gonna do is my dad's 4430. It's a very nice tractor, and I'm gonna replicate that in Farm Sim. And then we should be haying pretty soon. My dad's going to the farm this week on his days off to help get stuff ready to go. I believe that we're just going to use sickle mowers again this year, but my dad did buy parts for his swather, so maybe we're going to be using his swather some. Maybe we'll be using it for slough hay. Last year we didn't get any slough hay, I don't think. I think everything was too full for that. But Some years we can get slew hay and other years we can't. Oops, that's not what I want. But it just depends on how much moisture we get during the year. And but yeah. So I actually don't believe that I bought my fuel trailer on this map. I'll have to do that. Yeah, I don't think that I did. So we're just gonna kinda go around this way now, I think. I know it's not the most realistic way, but we're gonna do it anyways, just for some of this. At least this strip, because I want to try and start going up and down now some more and making less round and round rows. So actually, I'm going to want to... Oh, no. I am going to go this way. Yeah, this Farmall 300 is definitely a very nice mod. The Model A is very nice as well. As, you know, the whole small farming pack really is very nice. Can't remember where I got it from. I know it's somewhere. I'm sure if you just search like FS15 small farm pack on Google or something, it'll show up somewhere. There's actually a couple new things that they added into the pack that wasn't in there in 13. Because in 13 this rake actually would ted the grass as well as rake it. But now they added this in there, this tedder. But I don't really want to use it. I don't really hardly ever ted grass. I just kind of bale it. I let the sun dry it, even though, you know, in Farm Sim, the sun doesn't actually dry the hay, which kind of sucks, but it'd definitely be nice to see that. So I did miss some spots with the sycamore. It's kind of hard not to sometimes. But it happens in real life too, where, you know, maybe the ground was a little lower in that spot, so the mower, the blade, or the sickle bar, I can't talk right. The sickle bar maybe, you know, hit the ground and bounced up, or hits a rock and bounces, and then you got a 18-foot strip of grass standing yet. But oh well, it happens. So yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna cut another field or not. I'm going to bale this field and see how many bales I get. I bought 100 cows and 100 beef, so we have 200 animals to feed. So we'll see how many bales we get off of the field and off of this field, and then we'll see if we need to cut more. I know there's a couple smaller fields on here as well, so maybe we'll cut those and see what we can get from those. But for now, we'll start off with this field and see how many bales we get off of it, and then go from there. We got another 5 minutes left on the video. I have a timer going on my phone. About another 5 minutes. I set it for a half hour, but sometimes the videos end up being a little longer, which I don't mind. I'm sure that you guys don't mind either. Yeah, I usually try and keep them around a half hour. For me personally, anything more than a half hour gets to be way too long, and I just kind of, my attention kind of goes away, really. You know, like 45 minute videos, I'll skip some of it just because I don't really want to sit there for 45 minutes. But, you know, like Ian Robson's videos, he has those about a half hour, so I kind of sit and watch the whole thing there. But, so now we're going to go like this, and I'm going to go along this curve here and rake along here now. So yeah, by where my dad lives, they have already started cutting hay down there, but it is very pathetic hay. The only reason they cut it is because if they didn't hurry up and cut it, it was going to just die on them. But when we went to South Dakota, there was a lot of nice windrows down there, a lot better than what, you know, what was up here, but... down where my dad is at, they haven't really had a whole lot of moisture. You know, up at our farm, though, there's been a lot more moisture. So, we should have a pretty good haying season this year. But, yeah, so, pretty poor windrows. They're really, really, really thin. You know, just... like, they could rake three of them together, and that would equal, you know, one of last year's windrows for them. That's how poor it is. But a lot of the wheat's looking good down there. Corn is looking good, too. So, hopefully that stuff turns out a little better, and hopefully we can get some more moisture. The northern part of the state has had a lot more moisture than, like, the central and southern part of the state. So, you know, it's... just kind of hit and miss a lot of times. You know, it's funny, like the Missouri River, storms will come up, and then once they hit the river, they split and go like right around us. And, you know, there was one time the storm came up, as soon as it hit the river, it split, went around the river, and connected again. And that's no joke. You know, that's exactly what it did, and that was just, it was ridiculous. And, you know, just crazy how that works sometimes. And then, you know, my aunt and uncle live like maybe 2 miles straight east of me, of my house, and, you know, maybe not even that far. And they got like the whole west side of their house, or no, the whole north side of their house, they have to re-side. Because of, they got major hail at their house. And then at my house, none. You know, it's just crazy how that works. It's just ridiculous. At how, you know, such a short distance, but such a big difference in weather. And quite crazy. So, the video's gonna come to an end here in just a moment. Guess I can just do my closing. Oh, and then there's one more thing I want to mention before I end the video. A lot of people like my intro, and, you know, it's alright. I don't mind it, but, you know, it's just... it doesn't go with the channel, really, you know, like with the music that it's got and stuff. And when I first made it, a lot of people said, you know, use country music instead. Well, the reason I didn't do that is because the intro was set up with this, you know, it was set up to go with this certain music. You know, so like, you know, when the Kraft Farms goes, you know, like, I don't know, it like goes towards the screen or whatever, you know, towards you and whatnot, you know, it's set to do that with the music. So if I added country music, you know, I'd either have to sit and find something that goes, you know, that has a kind of a beat like that, which is hardly anything, because that's not how country music is. You know, otherwise it would just be completely, you know, random and, you know, wouldn't make much sense. So what I'm going to do once haying starts and, you know, I'm up at the farm, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a brand new intro that I'm going to have country music with. So, you know, I'm going to, because this year I want to try and get more real life videos out and more pictures and stuff. I'd like to get a better camera than what I have, because now I have to use my phone because of the camera that I have is crap, really. So I'm going to be using my phone, so it doesn't provide the greatest video quality, but sadly soon I might have to upgrade to an iPhone 6. I might get like a 6S. Because at the moment I have a 5S, and I have had so many issues with this phone where, you know, it'll say that I have an invalid SIM or no SIM card installed. And my dad and I are going to take it to, my dad and I are going to take it to Verizon and have them look at it and just see if we can figure out, you know, maybe it's just something stupid inside of it that they can fix, or if I have to get a new phone. And, you know, I would like to keep the 5, but I know I can't. So I'd probably go to like a 6S maybe. I definitely would not get a 6 Plus. That is way too dang big. You know, the 5S is large enough, really, for me. I don't need a giant phone, but oh well. So, but yeah, so once we start haying, I'm going to make a new intro, you know, do a little bit of, you know, I'm going to add an action shot of, you know, the haying, of like cutting, a little bit of raking, a little bit of baling, and then, you know, do like a snippet of farm toy stuff, and then a snippet of farm sim, and, you know, add that stuff in, add some country music, and then, I might make new channel art too, you know, have like a picture of the Hain crew or something like that, and then, you know, a picture of the farm, and then like a picture of a farm sim thing, and then add those together and, you know, make a channel art out of that, which I think would be quite neat, actually. Something similar to what, like, How Farms Work did with their channel art. Because they have like 3 pictures added together. So I probably would do something like that. Just because that would be kind of neat. So, yeah, guys. That's going to be it for this video. I'm going to finish raking this. And then I'll make another video while I bale it. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more videos. And if you enjoy the current videos, be sure to check out down below in the description. I will link that Q&A video, so make sure you go ask questions if you haven't already. I also have links to my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that you can check out. And I will see you guys in the next video. So thanks.